raised the desire that after the oration, you, as chief executive of the nation, formally set apart these grounds to their sacred use by a few appropriate remarks. Well, that's pretty clear, isn't it? My remarks are to be few, and they are to be appropriate. It will be an opportunity for me to lay before the American people my own thoughts on this great and terrible war, on what it might mean in the context of our nation's brief but eventful history. I need to remember, we need to remember, you're in on this with me now, that I was specifically directed to make my remarks appropriate as well as few, to consecrate. No, I think I need a different word here. Oh, I know where to look. Have you heard of this new work by this fellow Roger? At Gettysburg, we will be dedicating, appropriating solemnly to a purpose, the ground in which our brave and fallen soldiers are being buried. Let's imagine ourselves there. We are gathered here. No, that sounds too much like a wedding. We are met. We are met on a great battlefield of our great civil war. I've been thinking about the overall structure of our speech. I'm thinking that it should have three parts: the past, present, and future. It's not like I could just sit down the day before a major speech and suddenly write it all out in a burst of inspiration, using the back of an envelope or whatever else was available at the moment. Yes, the Bible is full of 80 years this and 80 years that. 87 years ago. 87 years ago. We still need to tie the war back to the beginning section, the part about our new nation. What does the war have to do with our nation? Why, is it not a test as to whether our nation will survive? Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation will long survive, can long survive, can long endure. Mary and I, along with John Hay and some other friends, are going to the theater tonight. Have any of you been to Ford's Theater since it reopened a couple of months ago? The show on Monday night was wonderful. Have any of you seen that youngest Booth brother perform yet? In my opinion, he isn't quite as talented as his brothers Junius and Edwin, but he sure is energetic and passionate. I've been thinking about the overall theme of the speech, that we might use this idea of dedication throughout. As they who died were dedicated to a great cause, so too we who are living must be dedicated to that same cause. Well, what did you think of the wedding? Miss Kate Chase did look beautiful in her fancy dress, don't you agree? And when she entered the room and the Marine Band played the Kate Chase March, especially composed for the occasion, that was quite impressive. In one sense, yes, we can dedicate that ground, but in another sense, in a higher or larger sense, we cannot dedicate it. Those brave soldiers who spilled their blood on that ground have already dedicated it. But maybe we needn't work so hard on this. It's just a little speech, just a few appropriate remarks. A few days afterwards, no one will even remember what we said. The world will little note, nor long remember, what we say here. He has one which turned out really nice. He thinks it captures me better than any other photo he's ever seen of me. It's just my head and upper body. I'm looking straight ahead, right at the camera. We need to define the cause for which our brave soldiers gave their lives. What exactly is that cause? These dead shall not have died in vain. Oh God, that they shall not have died in vain. I told him to change the schedule and have us go up the day before instead. The day before, of course, is tomorrow. And because of that, we've had to reschedule a few other things. Well, tomorrow I go. Wish me luck. Oh, perhaps you'd like to come along. I'd like that if you could. You've been a lot of help to me. Oh, there you are. I've been searching through all the cars looking for you. I thought maybe you'd fallen asleep and missed a connection. I wanted to let you know what I've been doing during the trip. After telling some stories, I got to thinking about my speech. I found a quiet place out of the way to read over it. I've made some changes and additions, and I wanted to share them with you. By the way, while I was working on my speech, I saw this feller across the way looking at me intently. And I thought to myself, this feller probably thinks that I'm just now starting to work on my speech. He will tell this to a friend later, who will tell it to someone else. And someday there will be a rumor about me writing my speech on the train on the way to Gettysburg. Four score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth upon this continent a new nation, that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and the government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth. My secretaries, Nicolay and Hay, have gathered some of the newspaper reports of the ceremony at Gettysburg. Let's see what they have to say. Of course, we know that the newspapers of our day are very partisan. The Republican papers always say nice things about me, and the Democratic ones say not so nice things. I suppose that will change someday. Perhaps in the 20th, or certainly by the 21st century, the news media will be much more unbiased and objective. Don't you agree? If it is the smallpox, however, I expect I will be quarantined for a little while, which means it's probably about time for you all to be going. I have greatly enjoyed your company over these past nearly 3 weeks. Thank you for your help in writing that speech. If it is remembered in the future, you can say that you had a little something to do with it.